When you use Revit MEP to create a duct system, there are three major processes involved: adding equipment, creating the logical system, and adding duct to create the physical system. To create a supply air system, begin by placing air terminals in the plan. On the Properties palette, use the Type selector to select the diffuser type, and then specify the distance you want the air terminals to be offset above the floor. Use the guides and snaps to assist you in placing the terminals in the model. Next, you place the air handling equipment using the same basic procedure. You select the equipment type from the type selector and then specify an offset distance from the floor. You can use the space bar to rotate elements when placing them in the model. Now you create the logical system by assigning the air terminals and air handling equipment to a supply system. First, select an air terminal, and then, on the Modify tab, click Supply. Total flow is based on the flow for individual components in the system. Edit the system to add or remove components from the logical system. In this example, the second diffuser is added to the system. Finally, click Generate Layout, and then use the layout tools to create and route ductwork connecting the air terminals and air handlers. Multiple layouts may be possible. You can use the controls on the options bar to cycle through the routing options. If you prefer, you can manually route the ductwork instead of using the layout tools. After you have completed the basic layout of the system, you can modify duct routing, align ductwork, and size duct as needed. You can follow this same workflow to create mechanical piping systems.